broad and kinetic, right? My nervousness, because we can pick this and talk about this and do all that, my only big issue is, can you sustain the humor at the same level and get the emotion to work and make us believe the fundamental story and the whole idea?
After you've gone through this long, black, dark tunnel, then you can really appreciate how great of a moment this was. And people that haven't been around the studio for a long time may not realize what a unique moment we just had with our screening. And after 10 minutes or 15 minutes, Peter and Tom say, well, we've said everything we need to say. We're going to take off. Keep going. I've never experienced anything like that before.
Boom, 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 boom.
Santa baby, just slip a sable under the tree for me. Been an awful good girl, Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney to me.
Imagined before that the world could be turned on its head. I'd never have thought to be here in this place.
We have a few simplifications that we want to do. We're going to introduce him. He is the emperor now, rather than what you saw in that reel. He was going to be the emperor the next day.
All right.
And it makes it a little simpler if he's just the emperor. Tomorrow is his 18th birthday. And he plots to kill it.
So I feel a little, I feel like I've almost got to the top of Everest and then I'm back down the ladder, you know, the snake or whatever it is. So I'm having to raise the energy to try and do this again. At a time when my mind is on doing other things. And the window of time I'd allotted for this is gone. And now I'm doing my album. So my head is in another creative space, and I'm being asked to switch 180 degrees to doing this. I'm not a quitter, but it's not an ideal situation for me to be in.
And what we're thinking on this first song is we've just got, you know, kind of some rough ideas that this song, which we just called working title Perfect World, is a song that we'll hear at the beginning of the movie and also at the very end. And then when we hear it at the end, it's a kind of song that can have the same chorus, but the verses here are very egocentric. In the end, I have a perfect world because I have, you know, I have friends.
Well, what attracted me about the old story in the first place was its epic scale. It was a kind of, you know, an Incan version of the Bible. It was like the creation in it, and it had up to present day in history, and it was a massive film. And now they've reduced it to smaller scale, you know, where it's about family and it's about friendship, all very good values. I'm not criticizing them, but it's not on the big scale anymore. So I'm just wondering whether my skills as a songwriter are necessarily pertinent to that kind of thing. The last time you showed the reel, you had a really great sort of Cuban
right, yeah. Yeah.
Thing happening, which I loved. I thought it was slick and funny and hip and sharp. I like that.
Yeah, so do we.
I like that.
This bit.
He sits down.
I like to be a craftsman. I like that. You know, I don't have to put my entire heart and soul into something. I'm not writing confessional songs about my passion. I'm writing about other people's issues, other people's problems. That's good. That's good therapy in a way. I'm in limbo at the moment. I'm not sure what. is going to happen.
I think now we've lowered our expectations from him just knowing what his schedule is like and what the demands of the film are. And I'm really hoping that he can work on our opening and closing song and do a song over the credit. I know he's really busy, and so we'll just see how that goes. We pitch to Peter and Tom all the time. Our current issue is the family. The family has not fired off as yet.
No, Daddy, you can't take him.
Look, don't worry, too, but he'll be all right. He looks at Cusco, gives him a hug goodbye. Cusco sort of tentatively pats him on the head, and then we hear...
For me, the movie comes to a dead stop when Pachi gets home to his village. And I love the idea of the village. For me, I love the kids, I love who he is. And
you know, actually, it just doesn't work.
It doesn't work.
Yeah.
But I'm not objecting to the family as an idea.
I just think it doesn't work.
It doesn't work. I think that the chess guy worked, the kids, everybody has to say the same thing.
We've done that.
What's that?
That's just a residual recording.
Yeah.
It's all cut. No one says wine anymore.
Okay. Fine.
There's no alcohol in the movie. They smoke pot now.
I thought it was funny.
I've gone through a bunch of permutations of Chicha, Pacha's pregnant wife. There were a lot of ups and downs, and do we have the sequence in the film, out of the film, and sometimes I'd walk by and they just have a meeting, and Mark would look like, Doug, we need to tell you something. I think Chicha may have been killed off. And so then I just say, you know, whatever's best for the story, just let me know what's going on. And then I'd walk through a couple weeks later, and Randy would come in and he'd say, you'll be happy to know that Chicha is in the film. Not a lot of her, but she's in the film. So I said, okay. And then Mark would come by and he'd say, you know what? We've just increased Chicha by 100%. There's a lot of Chicha in the film. And then the next week, Mark would say, Doug, we got to sit down. Chicha's back in the grave.
Dad's home!
Family at the end, again, I didn't need them. I didn't need
them. Well, you need the family at the end. They're just, you don't like them enough yet.
Why do I need them?
Because it's not interesting to have a single guy who lives all by himself who doesn't have any...
You're right.
I mean, it's only fun if Cusco goes from his whole empty world where he has nobody in the palace who likes him, and he joins up with a guy.
I'm talking about
to have a family.
No, I appreciate it.
So that's what makes it interesting.
It keeps changing, and therefore it will change and change and change and change, and it is that additive process that keeps making it
Although
fresh.
I don't recall one that quite has changed. We always say, oh, this is normal. Everything's like, we've never been through this before.
So clearly we're not yet heading in the right direction. We're going to go back with the story crew. Tom had some great ideas. We're going to try to incorporate those, go back again, and see if we can make it work.
Two and a half years.
2 years last February.
And February we were young men when we started this thing.
You turned gay.
Yeah. Never complained before.
I think the gag is a stop on the word trees, rather than the whole line.
Trees.
The last time we tried this, we just had a piano. It wasn't really vibey. I wasn't in the right mood, but you know, Dave's done a great arrangement of the song with instrument, you know, saxophone, trumpets and stuff, and rhythm section, and it's got a vibe, so we're going to have another go at it, give it our best shot and see what happens. we are again.
2.5 years later.
There are despots and dictators, political manipulators. There are blue bloods with the intellects of fleas. There are kings and petty tyrants who are so lacking in refinements. They'd be better suited swinging from the trees.
Come out and hang out with Tom Jones, my new close friend.
What? You pussycat?
Oh yeah! He's the sovereign lord of the nation. He's a hippest cat in creation. He's the alpha, the omega, A to Z. And this perfect world will spin around his every little whim. Cause this perfect world begins and ends with...
What's his name?
Cusco! That's his name! He's the king of the world! He's a hippo! What?
Cusco!
Yeah!
Ow!
Oh, well, you're about to spot a very humble baby. Nope.
I'll be the sovereign queen of the nation. I'm the chicest chick in creation. I'm the cat with all the cream and ooh la la. That deadly concentration put an end to my frustration. Now this present world begins and ends with mwah. What's my name?
Eva.
What's my name?
Eva.
What you say?
Eva. Eva.
According to this line here, I'm 29.31% done on prom.
Schedule's been really, really ramping up to the point where we're racing through these scenes. Deadlines start to get real, the release date's coming at you like a brick wall. Everybody's killing themselves now to get it done. This is the time where all socializing has basically stopped and we just pass each other in the halls like zombies. Hey, how you doing?
Show Michael Eisner plus Sting, the whole movie, completely for the first time. It's actually very exciting. We're like little children at the principal's office waiting to find out what the verdict is.
Gentlemen, when you've achieved genuine human values, you don't need a theme park or a water slide. I've been aware for a while now that my vision of the world and Disney's may be at odds. I can only be candid, but there's something intrinsically faulty with this film, and I find it very difficult to continue working on something that goes against my beliefs. I offer my views humbly, and I look forward to your response. Yours sincerely, me.
Does everyone know about this letter?
No, not everybody.
Sting, would have, if we show, if we